Everyone's had that moment where they walk across their carpet and reach for a door handle, only to be greeted by an irritating shock. This phenomenon is known as static electricity, and a more drastic example can be seen when lightning occurs. Although chemists and physicists are unsure of how exactly static electricity works, many theories have sprouted as the scientific importance of static electricity and its implications continue to grow. Static electricity is also known as tribal electricity, or rubbing amber, due to Thias of Miletus discovering an electric charge occurring after rubbing amber with wool. However, we know today that static electricity does not only occur through frictional contact. Just touching is sufficient for static electricity to be initiated, and for static electricity to occur, there needs to be an imbalance of charge in a material that remains until it can be balanced. So what happens when you walk across a carpet that gives you electric shock when metal is touched? When you walk across a surface, you're causing a transfer of electrons to occur, since contact between you and the floor initiates a chemical reaction that allows the more electronegative material to take electrons. You can magnify the extent of the transfer of electrons by wearing sock material that tends to give up more electrons, such as wool. Triboelectric series charts show materials that tend to give up more electrons on top and materials that tend to take electrons on the bottom. Once you give up some electrons, which have a negative charge, to the floor material, you're positively charged. As soon as you touch metal, which readily gives up electrons, electrons flood through skin contact to balance out the positive charged atoms and you receive an electric spark. This cannot happen when you're wearing polyester or rubber materials on your feet, since these materials tend to take electrons through floor contact and will not need to take any more from touched metal. Additionally, the loss of electrons causes hair to stand, due to repulsion between the hair strands from the increase in positivity. This is similar to two positive sides of a magnet repelling. You can even take a balloon, rub it on your hair so it gains electrons, and temporarily stick it to a wall as electrons attempt to cross over to the wall and, in doing so, pin the balloon. Static electricity also occurs between the ground and clouds during lightning, where particles touching within clouds generate static electricity, and the temperature at the point of electron transfer, or a thunderbolt, can reach over 50,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Static electricity also has many applications, such as in toner printers. In toner printers, a small wheel applies a negative charge to a larger wheel. The larger wheel is then exposed to a light that neutralizes the charge in any blank areas of the picture. After it has passed through the light, it is exposed to the ink toner, which is made with a positive charge that allows the ink to stick to all negatively charged areas. Finally, the wheel presses the ink into a paper below. The demand for higher quality printers sparked research in static electricity, no pun intended, and static electricity will continue to be studied as technology continues to advance.